The Honda WRV in its PS6 form has entered the market recently. The pandemic did have a part to play and the launch of the facelift got delayed. Of course, there are updated engines, but there's a lot more to talk about in this car. That includes looks and also features. We've established that the WRV is a premium hatchback, but it goes up against the subcompact SUVs in the market too because of the features and space it has to offer, as also the price point. Now with the facelift, there's a lot to look forward to. Well, as you'd expect from a facelift, the face has changed completely on the WRV. The grille is a huge departure from what we saw on the car earlier. In fact, this is much bigger in size now. I think it suits the style of this car even more. Along with that, new projector headlamps with LED DRLs, though it's a bit of a struggle to find those really small DRLs. Apart from that, the car also gets a new bumper and new fog lamps, and the change is for good, I must add. 16-inch alloy wheels are now standard and are a good fit in the muscular wheel arches, which give it that stance. Around the rear, there are C-shaped LED tail lamps which we've seen on the car earlier, so not much has changed there. In fact, the car continues to get the same 6 color options as before, and one that you see here is called the Radiant Red. But we wish there were some gold tone options available with the car. But let's get to the biggest change that the WRV gets. The BS6 engines. Both the petrol and diesel engines on the WRV remain the same. Of course, they are BS6 compliant now. But what I fail to understand is that why does the WRV still does not get an automatic gearbox with either of the engines? In fact, it is the only car in the entire Honda portfolio, starting from Amaze all the way to the CR-V, that does not get an automatic gearbox with either of the engines. We did ask Honda why it's so, and it said that customers prefer the manual transmission. The one we are driving is the diesel, and it comes with a 6-speed gearbox. We wish it was smoother though when it comes to slotting in gears. With the 200 Nm torque kicking in early, this engine is enthusiastic and you'll enjoy driving it out on the highway or even in traffic situations because the clutch is lighter. With 99 bhp on offer, there's good amount of power available for this premium hatchback. And the added advantage is that the diesel is big on fuel economy, offering 23.7 km per litre. Go down by 2 km per litre. It puts a whole bunch of subcompact SUVs, premium hatchbacks, and even some subcompact sedans to shame. The 1.2 litre petrol motor churns out 89 bhp and generates a peak torque of 110 Nm. The claimed fuel efficiency here is 16.5 km per litre.
Talking about ride and handling, nothing really changes when compared to the pre-facelift car. That's because there wasn't really anything to complain about on that aspect on the WRV right from day one. So the suspension is tuned well, it is able to take on the challenges the roads would throw at it.
The suspension ensures that you have a comfortable ride. There's no lateral movement even if you hit a big pothole. It takes all the undulations on the road in its stride. In fact, 188 mm of ground clearance also puts the mind at ease, especially when it comes to dealing with bad roads. Let's get to the features then. The electric sunroof has always been a huge novelty on the car, and Honda would be hoping it will continue to attract consumers. Then there's a new 7-inch touchscreen infotainment system, or DigiPad 2.0, which is standard on the WRV. The system is Android Auto and Apple CarPlay compatible. It also gets inbuilt navigation, but the interface could have been better.
Well, you're never far away from finding an ideal drive position on the WRV. That's because you have a driver's seat height adjuster, and along with that, a tilt and telescopic steering wheel. This wheel also gets new buttons for voice, audio, hands-free, as well as cruise control, which you see right here. Apart from that, the armrest has also gone for a change. It has more space now and it can fit in a full-size tablet, but it's a bit too low for my liking.
The newly designed seat upholstery with a mesh pattern looks good. You get a good amount of space in the second row, but you do miss the AC vents at the rear and even a center armrest. Boot space remains unchanged at 363 liters, which is more than adequate. It's big on safety too and comes with ABS with EBD, rear parking camera, impact mitigation front headrest, and pedestrian injury mitigation technology, all of which are standard. The WRV is offered in just two variants, SV and VX, in both petrol and diesel. Prices started 8.5 lakh rupees for the petrol and go up to 10.99 lakh rupees for top end diesel. That makes it more comparable to many subcompact SUVs on sale currently in the market, more so the top variants. The top variant of Maruti Suzuki Vitara Brezza manual is priced at 9,98,000 rupees, while for the WRV it costs 9,69,000 rupees. Ford EcoSport's top end diesel variant is priced at 11.67 lakh rupees, while for Hyundai Venue it is 11.52 lakh rupees. And the WRV is much more expensive than its closest rival, the Ford Freestyle, which starts at 5.99 lakh rupees. The WRV then makes quite an impression then, because it now offers a lot more in terms of features and standard equipment. However, the lack of an automatic gearbox does hurt, and that's probably one reason why it doesn't stand out in the crowd.